I'm going to be making a very simple chicken, and I should be using mustard, lemon, garlic, butter, rosemary, and some other seasonings. So this is something you can make when you really don't feel like cooking. It's a quick recipe, so stay tuned and make it yourself. That's about exactly 800 grams of boneless chicken fillets, and I've got some butter here, some mustard, some honey, some salt, and some pepper. And over here, some garlic. That must be at least 3 to 4 garlic sliced, and one medium onion, some rosemary, 2 tomatoes, 1 capsicum, and 1 lemon. Season the chicken with salt and freshly ground black pepper. And in a pan like this, I've taken 2.5 tablespoons of butter, added 2 tablespoons of olive oil. The garlic is right there, and that's 1 tablespoon of rosemary. Once that is melted, I'm going to be browning the chicken in this pan, both sides, 2 to 3 minutes. And when it's done, you have to remove it. I'm going to lightly brown this. I love the combination of butter, olive oil, and garlic, and rosemary, my goodness. This rosemary I brought from Chitral. It's been with me for a long time in the freezer. And let me tell you, this is the freshest rosemary I've ever used. If you guys want, we can call for some rosemary from Chitral. After that's done, I'm just going to remove the chicken, leave the juices behind, add a little more butter, onion, two small chopped green chili. I don't know if I mentioned that earlier, it was right there, sauté. Season that with salt and pepper. Add the green capsicum. You can add any color you like. I had green, so that's what's going to do today. It's gonna have to do. Okay, lemon. I'm gonna try with just half a lemon first. So these are nice and juicy, there's a lot in it, and there are no seeds, so yay! Honey, at least 2 to 3 tablespoons, you can always add more. Some mustard, 1 tablespoon of mustard. And guys, I want you to taste this before you proceed, because at this point you can add salt. If you feel like there's less honey, you add that now. I felt the honey was less, so I added in total 4 tablespoons of honey, and I added a little bit more lemon juice. Now guys, lemon juice is a personal preference. Add at least one and then see how you feel. I'm just deglazing this by adding some hot water. Once this boils, I should be adding the chicken to this. Add the chicken, coat it well. Now at this point, I'm going to cover this for a little while. It doesn't matter if the capsicum and the tomatoes are soft. Sometimes that's fine too. Just a little bit. And that's done. I'm just going to take a little bit of chives or green onions, cut them into thin pieces and garnish that. This is a very versatile recipe. If you want to make it into a keto recipe, all you need to do is add some cream. If you want to be more healthy and conscious, remove the butter and add olive oil. Although let me tell you, the butter is what makes it so good. Now you can use a lot of other stuff in this recipe. Like for instance, you can add green beans, you can add some kidney beans. I would have added some olives, which I should have, but I didn't. There's so many things one can do with this recipe. You can eat this with brown bread or over some rice, pasta, anything. It's a very yummy, easy recipe. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Chop the spring onions with a pair of scissors. It's very easy, it's very precise. You guys should use it for a lot of herbs. And here it is, guys. I hope you like this recipe, and I should be posting it soon.